So today we are going to start with fiber bending losses. How the bending losses is taking place in optical fiber, we are going to see in today's session. So to understand the fiber bending losses, these are the outlines. First, we'll discuss the basics of fiber bending losses. Then we'll explain the types of fiber bending losses, in which we will cover macroscopic bending loss and microscopic bending losses, or one can say micro bending loss, and micro bending losses, that is even referred as mode coupling losses. So let us begin the session with first agenda, that is basics of fiber bending loss. Now let us see the basics of fiber bending loss. Bending loss is a loss that happens with the fiber due to bending of fiber. So whenever you will be observing the bending of fiber, there will be changing in the radius of curvature. So for example, if fiber is straight like this, then its radius of curvature is uniform throughout. But when you bend the fiber, you will be finding its radius will change at some position. So at some position, its radius will increase or its radius will decrease. And because of change in the radius, there is a possibility of signal is getting radiated out of the fiber. So if there is any change in the radius of the curvature, there can be a radiation loss taking place from the fiber. If there is a sharp bend of the fiber, then there is a probability of mechanical failure of optical cable. So if you bend it more, then in that case it is possible there is mechanical failure, which is permanent failure, where you cannot have any communication. So this is what, not partial loss, it is complete loss. But when up to some extent some bending is happening, at that time there is some losses taking place. So in this session we will talk about that losses which is happening because of bending, which will not be based on mechanical. Usually you will be observing the higher order modes are not tightly bound to the core layer, and because of that sharp bends will result radiation loss in fiber. And as I have told you, when you bend fiber, at that time at some position radius of a fiber will decrease for core region. And as for core region the radius of fiber decreases, higher order modes will radiate out. Now see how it will happen. So if you observe optical fiber, in that higher order mode, in that higher order mode that is having radiation field which is more portion in core region, if you see lower order mode, in that case you will be observing field region that is more focused on in axis of fiber. So less amount of energy that is there in the region of core. So you can see by shape I have drawn it here, as if you decrease the radius, you can observe more field that will go in cladding region. As if you decrease the radius, as more field is going into cladding region, there is more possibility of radiation of signal which is there inside of fiber. So here major issue, that is change in radius, and that effect will be more to higher order modes, as higher order modes are not tightly bound to the core layer, and lower order modes that is tightly bound to the core layer. So there will be less effect to lower order mode compared to higher order mode. So here when we talk about the types of fiber bending losses, Then there are basically two types of fiber bending losses. One is macroscopic bending loss and second is micro bending losses, or one can say mode coupling losses. So let us discuss macroscopic bending loss. Now see, first of all we should know what is microscopic bending. See, when you have optical fiber and bending of fiber is happening at some region, and if you observe the radius of bending, and if radius of bending is bigger than the radius of optical core, then that bending is referred as macroscopic bending. Let us see few cases. You can see this is what fiber and is bent from this portion. Now if you see this radius is this much for this curve, and if you see this is the radius of curve, and if you observe the radius of this fiber, then the radius of curve is bigger than the radius of fiber, and this bending is referred as macroscopic bending, or one can say macro bending. Let us see few more cases. Like see, if the fiber is bent at 90 degrees, that is the fiber is bent at some 45 degrees, so here even there is this radius is this much, core radius is this much, so bending radius is bigger than the radius of core, and that is referred as macroscopic bending. Now because of this bending, there is a possibility of that signal will go out of this fiber. Now see, examples are given by yellow color, the signal is traveling like this, but because of this bending this signal is getting radiated out, and this is what macro bending loss. Here even that happens, like see, the signal is coming from here, and after having reflection from here it is moving out of the fiber. Now see how that happens, why that happens. When bending is happening, this radius will decrease. So as this radius is decreasing, we can observe more field that will go inside cladding region and less field get bounded in core region. Then that will result into radiation of signal out of that fiber. One more thing that we need to understand here, as if you have lower order modes, so lower order modes are having fields like this. As field for lower order modes is like this, if radius is decreased because of bending, then as field is more focused towards the core region, there will be less radiation, so effect to lower order modes will be less as compared to higher order modes. So macroscopic bending loss that happens because of bending of fiber, and macroscopic bending means radius of bending that is higher than the radius of the core of fiber, and that loss is happening because of decreasing radius at some region because of bending, and that is having effect which is having more with higher order modes compared to lower. And here one more thing we need to understand, when macroscopic bending happening, at that time there is a signal which will go in cladding region, and when the signal goes in cladding region, and as if we want to receive that at other hand, then that is having bigger travel path compared to the travel path which is there with core. Like see, if I consider one case over here where one ray is going like this, but because of this bending, now that ray is now traveling through cladding. When this ray is traveling through cladding, it is having larger path compared to the path which is there with core. So when that happens, that ray which is there in the cladding region will be traveling with faster velocity, then only it will reach at the same compared to signal which is passing through the pole. So because of bending, when a signal goes in the gliding region, it should be traveling faster to avoid further losses which is happening because of signal passing through pole, like that gliding region. And there are few signals which will radiate out of the fiber. So these are the losses which is there in macroscopic bending loss. So as I have mentioned all those points, there is a radiation loss when radius of curvature of bend is greater than the diameter of fiber. Such losses are referred as large radius losses, and which is what macroscopic bending loss. As radius of curvature of bend decreases, losses will increase exponentially. So radius of curvature is very important parameter. As I have told you, the signal should pass through core region. If radius of curvature decreases, field will go in cladding and there will be a possibility of losses of signal which is there in core region. And for that, all we need is we need to operate with lower mode, which is having lower field in cladding region, and that is tightly bounded in core region, that one can see over here. There is certain critical value of radius of curvature up to which such losses can be observed. So up to some extent losses will happen, but after some extent signal will have exponential decay. In optical cable, the wavefront is perpendicular to direction of propagation, and that must be maintained to achieve this part of mode, which is on the outside of the band, must travel faster. So as I have told you, when signal goes in cladding, it should travel faster as it is having longer trajectory compared to the trajectory is present in the core region. So when signal goes in cladding, it should travel faster. So energy associated with that part is lost to radiation, and that happens, as I have told you, the agenda is to send via core only, but when it goes in cladding, there is no possibility to go outside. Now let us discuss micro bending losses, or one can say mode coupling losses. So here are few cases I have shown. Now micro bending means small bending. There is small bending is here. So now this small bending that happens because of some reasons, and those reasons I have listed, and you can see this is the signal which is passing through the core optical cable, but because of this bending it is going out. So this kind of small bendings will create issues regarding micro bending losses. And here mode coupling losses is given a name. Why mode coupling is given as a name? Like you can see, like here the radius, only this radius. When we consider this radius here, because of this band, one can see the radius of this diameter cable is this one. So there is drastic change in the radius happens. Many modes cannot propagate through cable. So here we can say even this mode coupling loss. As your mode will get coupled, and this loss will be more severe. So these are the losses due to small bending or small distortion. If there are small fluctuations in the radius of curvature of fiber axis, then micro bending are created and the light rays radiate out from this micro bends. So when this kind of bend is happening, there is possibility of radiation of signal out of fiber. Now why micro bends are formed in optical cable? So there are major two reasons. One is non-uniformity in the pore radius while manufacturing the cable. During manufacturing, they should take care of with pore radius. If there is any non-uniformity in the pore radius, then there are microbend loss which happens. During the cabling of fiber, non-uniform lateral pressure can be created. Like see, when you connect optical fiber from source to destination, and if you do underground cabling, so in underground cabling, because of pressure on cable, there can lateral pressure on cable, there can be small bend. There is one more way by which microbend loss may happen. Like see, if you hang it in air, you will have to stick this wire to the wall. To stick that wire to the wall, we clip it with a clip over here, and when you clip with the clip over here, there will be a higher tension on this wire, and the tension will create microbend in optical cable. So that is even one more issue which is resulting into microbending loss. Now how to overcome those issues regarding microband? So one way that we can manufacture the cable with precise control of core diameter. So as if you manufacture optical cable with precise core diameter, in that case we can avoid it, and that is regarding manufacturing issue resolving. But when we talk about cabling, so at that time we use compressible jacket, and if we use compressible jacket, then we can avoid some lateral uniform pressure. Like see, when you hang it from one wall to other wall, and if you use compressible jacket at the wall, then fiber will not suffer with lateral pressure, jacket will suffer with lateral pressure as it is compressible. So there will be less effect on fiber, and that will avoid this microbending loss. So by using compressible jacket and by having precise fabrication of core diameter, we can avoid microbending losses up to some extent. I hope you have understood this microbending and macrobending losses in optical fiber cable.